the energy vibration reading for the Aries Sun, Moon, and Rising sign. I want to say thank you for being here. Thank you for being back. Thank you for this wonderful, wonderful support. I want to say to each and everyone that this month I am going to be basically doing this month as a dedication and a thank you gift to someone, one of my subscribers who have donated to this channel so that we can keep these free readings going. So this is wonderful. So at the beginning of the videos, you will see a doll that we are dedicating this month to a wonderful person who has supported us in staying with us, supporting us, and I want to say thank you. Thanks to each and every person. Thank you so much for coming back. Thank you for all the positive energies that you have sent. I want to say to each and every person, this is a month where there is going to be a lot going on, but it is a grounded month. It is the month of fire, hurt. So this is good. It's the month of earth, so this is positive energies. Okay, let's see what is happening, what is going on for you Aries in the month of July. Month of July is the energy of the Aerophant. It's an earth energy where a lot of people will be working out a lot of karmatic situation with each other. Now, this is a positive energy because the beginning of the month is going to be water. The two first week is going to be water, so be aware of that. And the two last week is going to be fire. You guys have the energy of the Chariot, and this is wonderful because with the energy of the Chariot, what happens is that in the two last week, a lot of positive situations are going to be coming up for you, a lot of movement. Some people will be buying new cars, some people will be working on their cars, some people will be moving from one place to another, some people will be aligning themselves with the right positive situation in their life, and this is going to be extremely good. So let's move in and see what is the energy for the first week for you. This energy keeps on coming up. Whatever is happening, this energy keeps on coming up. The Seven of Swords. So a lot of, you know, someone, deceitfulness and that sort of a thing. And someone is trying to get away with something. Some deceitfulness will be going on around you. But you're going to overcome this. And this is wonderful. Whatever the deceitfulness that has been going on around you, you are going to be overcoming this. And this is good. This is a wonderful positive energy because you have overcome this deceitfulness. Whatever the deceitfulness and the lies was, you have overcome this. And this is positive because what this is going to, what this is saying is that in the second week, with the energy of you looking within and trying to find out what exactly had gone on, you're going to win this victory and overcome this deceitfulness that you had to deal with in the first week. Okay, let's see what's coming out for the third week. The Lovers. This is positive. This is wonderful. This is good. Energy of the Lovers. Another wonderful card. So some of you could be meeting a twin flame or a soulmate, okay? A twin flame or a soulmate. Whatever the situation is or was, it's going to be turning out in a very positive way because in the third week, you could be connecting with the right company, right organization, right group of people in the third week of July. This is good. It is more of a soulmate energy, so you'll be connecting with people on the work floor in a soulmate energy. And then we have the energy of the Hermit in the last week. This is a water energy. Now the last week is the energy of the same energy as the Hierophant. So a lot of you will be seen through the veils of a situation. A lot of you will be seen through the veils of a situation. And this is going to be wonderful because it could be a relationship that you'll be seeing the truth of a situation in a relationship, okay? So what I'm seeing is that some deceitfulness went on in relationship, but you have used your intuition and intelligence to cut through whatever the deceitfulness was. And this is wonderful and positive because what is happening is that you have seen and realized that certain things wasn't above water with the energy of the lovers, okay? So it's as if you're seeing a situation with your partner, and especially if you are married, it's as if the truth is coming out, the light of the truth is coming out, okay? So let's see what is happening with the energy of the seven. It has to do with money. So there was some lie and deceitfulness, and whatever this lie and deceitfulness, it has to do with money. Someone was trying to get away with something that has to do with money. And at the end of the first week, going in the second week, you are going to be realizing that. You're going to be realizing that, but you're going to be victoriously overcoming this. Let's see the energy of the Ace of Swords and the Lover. That means it's a new start with communication. You're going to be having a new start with someone. With positive new communication, you're going to be having a new start with someone. So let's see here. What's happening with the Queen of Pentacles? So with the Queen of Pentacles, communication, with positive communication, you are going to be resolving a situation with someone between the ages of 25 and 45 that is that is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. Yeah, that is a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. So with positive communication, you are going to default whatever the situation is or was, and you are going to be resolving this. Then as we move to the Lovers and the Hermit, you have the Ace of Pentacles. So this is a wonderful month for you guys because you have the Ace of Swords and the Ace of Pentacles, and this is going to be extremely positive. In a very, very positive way, okay? So what has transpired, I'm seeing that someone tried to get away with a situation with what has to do with money. But you, whether with your communication or your intellect, you have used the sword of truth to bring out the truth in a situation. Then you are going to overcome a situation that you have to deal with the Queen of Pentacles and the Lovers. Now, this could be a relationship that you're in, or it could be a situation where you have to pay this person some money, okay? We have this, the Lovers and the Ace of Pentacles. The Lovers and the Ace of Pentacles, which come out with the energy of you looking at a situation for what it is. Okay, so let's see. Five of Pentacles and the Queen of Swords. You have the Eight of Swords. Some of you are not seeing a situation, and the situation is going to clear up because some of you are not seeing a situation for what it is. It's as if you expect this person to understand your financial situation or that sort of a thing, and she's like, nope, I'm not having it. And you know, if you borrow something, you should return it, okay? The Queen of Pentacles and the Ace of Pentacles, you have the Seven of Cups. Okay, so what is happening here is that this Queen of Pentacles is as if she has money, and you think that she has money, so, and she doesn't want to help you help you out of a situation, but it's not her you know, it could be your daughter or that sort of a thing, but it is as if she needs it herself, okay? The Six of Cups is a past life situation. Six of Cups, a past life situation. So the outcomes is a Three of Cups. There's going to be a celebration. Okay, so let's look at your reading in positive sense. Some of you, or maybe someone, was trying to get away with a situation with money. You're not seeing the situation clearly, but the situation rises from a past life thing. It's as if you have money for this person from out of a past life, and you are supposed to pay this person back. As we look at the energy of the Hermit, is shedding light on to let you know that a new opening up is going to be coming, and a new healing for your financial situation is going to be coming, and there are multiples of opportunities that are out there, and that is going to come to you, and this is a very, very good. Now, in the middle, the energy of the Ace, the Lovers, and the Ace of Swords is a positive energy bar, where a lot of you will be connecting in a positive way, because you'll be connecting together back with your relationship to speak, by speaking up and speaking the truth. A lot of you are going to be able to overcome a lot of situations in your life, okay, just by speaking out and saying exactly how things are. You're going to be able to overcome a situation in your life. Okay, so this is basically good. The energy of the Lovers with the Ace of Swords is a positive energy. Whatever way you look at this, it is basically a positive energy, in the sense that what it is doing, it is really helping you to communicate with someone who you love. As a matter of communicating with someone who you love, and this is extremely good, because the energy with the Lovers and the Hierophant has to do with the physical, the practical matters in love, where you're looking at situation. So it says marriage and ritual, the exchange of the vows, sexual intercourse, and that sort of a thing. So we need to be aware and align ourselves with the truth of what is happening around us. And this is a month that whatever the situation is, you're going to be victoriously coming out of this situation. Okay, so let's move on, because this month I've changed up the reading. We are going to be doing a mirror effect of your month to see what is the underlying energies that are at this time. So let's see for you guys what is happening. So for the month of July, for the Aries, I'm asking the angels and guides to show us what is the mirror of this reading. There's a lot of conversation that will be going on, a lot of conversation that will be going on. So be aware of this. And then luck. It's so positive. This energy coming up in the middle of the month, a lot of luck is going to be coming to you guys. And the Far East, we have luck with a new start and a new beginning. Okay, so a lot of talking, a lot of situation, a lot of talking, but there is going to be luck with a new start and a new situation. There's information that is going to be coming at you. Information about money. Information about money is going to be coming to you. And there could be a fast pace. Yeah, information about money is coming to you in a very fast pace. A very, very fast pace. And then there is going to be changes. There's going to be changes. Whatever the changes that is going to be happening, is going to give you a strong foundation and this situation. So let's see the outcomes. There is a lot of negative energies, negative situation that is coming out for you guys, okay? That's kind of weird. Because there is lack. There should be lack coming into you guys. And it's as if this lack that is coming in, all of a sudden, there is this there's lack with a new start, but all of a sudden there is a situation. So there's a lot of jealousy. There is a lot of jealousy that is around you. Pay attention to this, because there is a lot of jealousy that is around you. You're going to receive sudden luck. Sudden luck with money. Sudden luck. Just sudden luck with money and a strong foundation. Sudden luck with money and a strong foundation. I'm seeing in the end of the month, you have a new start, and this new start is going to bring you financial abundancy, okay? This new start is going to bring you some financial abundancy. There's going to be sudden luck that is coming in, and it's going to bring you balance. And this new start is going to bring some stability with your financial situation, okay? And this is going to be very positive. Whatever the blocks that is going to be coming up is because of jealousy. So not to worry about this, because it's as if just ask the universal angels and guides to remove these blocks that is coming up, because I see a situation where there is going to be, you know, it's as if people are trying to create a situation that is not there. So, try not to be late with whatever payments that you have at the end of the month of July. But it's a positive month, because as I look at your reading, there is going to be a lot. The gossip and stuff is going to come to an end. Okay, the gossip and stuff that is happening is going to come to an end. It's going to come to a fast end. And there is a new start and a transition that is coming up for you guys, which is so very positive. There's information that is coming, and this information is going to come fast about money. There is some of you will be moving, and this move is going to bring stability, but it's going to bring like as if you know, a problem if you're late with your payments and that sort of a thing. But not to worry about it, because this is really, really, really going to be resolved, okay? Not to worry about this, because this is going to be resolved, whatever that is coming up. So I'm seeing here the energy, because I'm seeing the energy of the Queen of Pentacles. Whatever that situation is, there is going to come an end to it. Whatever dysfunctional behaviors that was happening between you and the Queen of Pentacles, that is going to come to an end. Okay, a new start is going to be coming in. Some of you, if you are looking for work, you're going to be receiving messages of invitation. Is coming in. Invitation is going to be coming in for work. Some of you, this situation is coming from or stemming from a past life. This situation is stemming from a past life. Okay, and whatever the situation is that some of you have great love for, it could be your daughter, but it could, you could be in a relationship with this person, but some of you are dealing with a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn person, because there is a new start that is coming for this person. And the situation is that in the past, you weren't seeing a situation clearly about this person. And now the Hermit is shedding a light on this situation. And this situation is going to be resolved. It's a past life issue. Some of you need to return or pay back this person, because what I'm seeing here is as if you don't want to pay back this person, but you need to pay back this person. Is a karmatic situation, okay? Because it's not they are supposed to pay you, it's you are supposed to pay back this person. Okay, your number is going to be number 7. You're on the good part. I'm seeing number 7. It's like an horseshoe coming up. It's like a U form. So it's a situation where you need to do the right thing. You need to understand where you are and do the right thing in whatever is happening, okay? You have the energy of the watermelon, tourmaline, and this is the crystal deck, and it says stress reduction. De-stress your mind, body, and schedule as you need to rest, recharge, and revitalize. Okay, so this is a beautiful, wonderful energy. If you feel like you need to rest, you should take the time and rest. I want to say to each and every person, namaste, until next time.